Okay, once again, very good morning to all of you. So now, who will tell me answer of this adjoint of B? सबने ट्राई किया, पहले वो आंसर देख लेते हैं, फिर लेट अस स्टार्ट न्यू टॉपिक. ओके, सो एडजॉइंट बी, जस्ट रेज योर हैंड जितने लोगों ने घर से ट्राई किया जिसका इसका आंसर आया. प्रवीण, ओके लेट मी चेक प्रवीण आंसर. सेम मिस्टेक प्रवीण. ओके, तो प्रवीण और भमिन ने मुझे आंसर भेजा है, बट देर इज वन मिस्टेक. ओके, आप उसके स्टेप्स याद करो. पहला स्टेप क्या था? पहला स्टेप भूल गए. हाँ, यस प्रवीण, यस राइट. फ्रॉम ए फर्स्ट यू हैव टू डू ट्रांसपोज, आफ्टर दैट यू हैव टू फाइंड इट्स एडजॉइंट, राइट. सो दिस इज शॉर्टकट फॉर फाइंडिंग को फैक्टर्स. दिस इज शॉर्टकट फॉर फाइंडिंग को फैक्टर्स एंड एडजॉइंट इज डिफाइंड एज को फैक्टर ऑफ ट्रांसपोज, राइट. एडजॉइंट इज डिफाइंड एज को फैक्टर ऑफ ट्रांसपोज, राइट. सो दोनों का आंसर राइट है, जस्ट ट्रांसपोज नहीं किया. ओके, सो योर फाइनल आंसर विल बी -6 8. ओके वेट, -6 8, -7, देन -7, -9 1, -22 11 11. ओके, सो दिस इज द थिंग. ओके, नाउ सी ओवर हियर. सो लेट अस स्टार्ट नाउ न्यू टॉपिक ऑफ लिनियर अलजेब्रा, दैट इज रैंक ऑफ मैट्रिक्स, राइट. एंड वी विल ट्राई टू फिनिश दिस रैंक ऑफ मैट्रिक्स इन 2 डेज, राइट, टुडे एंड टुमारो. ओके, एंड फ्राइडे एंड सैटरडे वी विल सी न्यूमेरिकल एप्टीट्यूड. सो हु विल टेल मी फर्स्ट व्हाट इज डेफिनेशन ऑफ रैंक ऑफ मैट्रिक्स? रैंक ऑफ मैट्रिक्स की डेफिनेशन क्या है? एनीवन? टू फर्स्ट फाइंड रैंक ऑफ मैट्रिक्स यू शुड रिमेंबर, यस हाँ, बट सो अमन इज आंसरिंग दैट नॉन जीरो रोज, यस आई कैन गेट इट, नॉन जीरो रोज, बट इजंट इट अ कंप्लीट डेफिनेशन? उसके अलावा भी कुछ होता है? क्योंकि डायरेक्टली नॉन जीरो रोज तो मैं इस पे नहीं लिख सकता, पहले मुझे उसको कोई फॉर्म में कन्वर्ट करना पड़ेगा. ओके, सो यस, रो इकलन फॉर्म, राइट. सो रैंक ऑफ मैट्रिक्स इट्स सिंबॉल इज रो. ओके, सो रैंक ऑफ मैट्रिक्स इज डिफाइंड एज नंबर ऑफ नॉन जीरो रोज इन इट्स इकलन फॉर्म और रो इकलन फॉर्म. सो रैंक ऑफ ए इज डिफाइंड एज नंबर ऑफ नॉन जीरो रोज इन रो इकलन फॉर्म ऑफ ए. नाउ यू विल आस्क मी सर व्हाट इज रो इकलन फॉर्म, राइट. ऑलरेडी आप पढ़ चुके हो, तो एक बार रो इकलन फॉर्म का हम रिविजन कर लेते हैं. दैट इकलन फॉर्म एक्जेक्टली होता क्या है, राइट. सी ओवर हियर. फॉर दैट आई एम गिविंग यू फ्यू एग्जाम्पल्स, जस्ट ऑब्जर्व दिस एग्जाम्पल्स. हाँ यस, देर इज आई विल डिस्कस ऑल द मेथड्स एंड ऑल द डेफिनेशंस. दिस इज योर फर्स्ट डेफिनेशन ऑफ रैंक ऑफ मैट्रिक्स. देर आर थ्री डेफिनेशंस ऑफ रैंक ऑफ मैट्रिक्स. रैंक ऑफ मैट्रिक्स विल सी ऑल थ्री ऑफ देम एंड बेस्ड ऑन ऑल थ्री यू आर गोइंग टू हैव क्वेश्चंस. ओके, सो जस्ट ऑब्जर्व दिस मैट्रिक्स इज स्टूडेंट्स, राइट. सो दिस इज योर फर्स्ट मैट्रिक्स, ए वन बी वन सी वन डी वन, 0 बी टू सी टू डी टू, 0 0 बी थ्री, और आई कैन से सी थ्री डी थ्री. अनदर मैट्रिक्स बी इज इक्वल टू 0 ए बी सी, 0 0 बी ई, देन 0 0 0 0. अनदर मैट्रिक्स इज A, B, C, D, 0, 0, E, F, then 0, 0, 0, 0. Another matrix is A, B, C, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. Another matrix is A, B, C, D, 0, E, F, G, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. So here, right, I have given you all these examples so that you can understand that what is rank of matrix. Okay. So let us observe these examples in detail. Now, can you able to see these examples, all of the examples together, isn't it? I think, let me reduce by one. Yes, right. Now see, you can see all these examples together, right? A, B, C, D. Now observe these examples. These all are of different forms of row echelon form only. Right. From here, you can clearly define that what do we mean as by row echelon form? What is the meaning of row echelon form? So see over here. So in this matrices, you can observe that first, leading zeros, right? Leading zeros in each one of row. In first row, here in first row, how many leading zeros are there? No, right? There is not any leading zero over here. In second row, how many leading zeros are there? In second row, there is one leading zero. In third row, there are two leading zeros. Okay. Here, one leading zero. Here, two leading zero. This is all zero row. Here, two leading zeros. Right. Here, all zero rows. Then here, one leading zero and all zero rows. So as you are going from top to bottom, that is, as your row number is increasing, right, your leading zero is increasing. So as your row number is increasing, so when you're moving from row one to row two, row two to row three, your leading zeros in that rows are increasing. Are you getting my point? So this is your first property of row echelon form. Second property. Sorry. Okay. Give me just a minute. Okay. So first property. Now second property. That number of, or I can say all zero rows. All zero rows are where? All zero rows are at bottom of matrix or not? Here it is one zero row. Here it is also zero row. Here two zero rows. Here also two zero rows. So all zero rows are at bottom of the matrix, isn't it? This is your zero row. This is also your zero row. Are you getting my point? Please give me some response. Right. This is your zero rows. Same here. These two are your zero rows. So all zero rows are at bottom of matrix. Okay. So this is your form of row echelon form. So अब आपको अगर ये याद रखना है, right? अगर आपको ये row echelon form याद रखना है, so for shortcut, right? Let me give a shortcut to remember this row echelon form and how we can convert any matrix into row echelon form. So for shortcut, just remember this staircase. Okay. See, why this staircase? This staircase will give you where there are non-zero numbers. This all are non-zero numbers. And in this staircase, you can observe that आपकी ये width है. This is your height. This is your width. Right. So your width can be longer. Right. Your width can be longer, but your height cannot be longer. Okay. So your width can be longer, but your height cannot be longer of this stair. See over here. So here, what is your stair? This is your stair or not? What is your stair from here? Exactly, this stair will begin from here. So this is your staircase. Okay. Now, so, or you can take this like this. Chalo, here, this is your staircase. This is your staircase. This is your staircase. Are you getting my point? Please give me some response. Okay. So this staircase will represent number of non-zero rows. Right. Since the star entities are non-zero, the star entities are non-zero elements. Okay. So this will represent non-zero rows. Right. So all non-zero rows are here only. So this is your first row, second row, third row. First row, second row, first row, second row, first row, first row, second row. So based on them, if I have to write their rank, what is rank of A now? In A, how many non-zero rows are there? Here A, B, C, D, all are non-zero. So rank of A is how much? Type in chat box. 3. Rank of B. Type in chat box. What is rank of B, students? 2. What is rank of C? Again 2. What is rank of D? 1. And what is rank of E? 2. Right, isn't it? Chalo. Why today students are less? Why today there are only 20 students? What about other students? They are sleeping, taking rest. Okay. So this is your definition of rank. Okay, our first definition of rank, that number of non-zero rows in its row echelon form. So this is how you have to convert any matrix, any given matrix into row echelon form. And how to convert any matrix in row echelon form, that I will show you. Wait. Okay. I will give you different definitions as well. But let us understand for first definition. Now examples based on first definition, then second and second definition of this. Okay. Now, so now to find rank of matrix, we need to convert any matrix into its row echelon form first. And how you can convert any matrix into row echelon form? Now let us see that. To convert any matrix into its row echelon form, my voice is breaking. Wait, so I think there are some net issues. Let me switch to another net source. Right. Okay. What about now? Is it still breaking? For how many of you my voice is breaking? Just raise your hand. Okay, for few of you it was breaking, right? Okay, so shall we continue now? It is breaking a little. From morning, we are facing this issue, I think. Let me change again. I think this is better, right? Okay. So to convert any matrix into row echelon form, see over here, you need to apply elementary operations, right? We have to apply elementary operations. Now, what are these elementary operations? Let us see them. Now, Now, in these elementary operations, there are, generally we are going to use these three operations. First is Ri can be interchanged to Rj. Now, when we were interchanging Ri to Rj, at that time in determinant, its value was changed by negative, or if it is positive, it will become negative. If it is negative, it will become positive. But in case of matrix, matrix is an arrangement. Determinant is one value. So in matrix, your whole arrangement is going to change. So we are going to get a new matrix. So it is called a transformation of matrix. Okay. Second, let us multiply Ri with Kri. Right? I can multiply K with any row or column. Okay. Third, the thing already we have used in mat determinant, that Ri can be changed to Ri plus Krj. Right? I can multiply K with any other row and I can add in particular row. Okay, so this all are your elementary operations. Right? And let us remember few basic rank also, or few properties of rank. So first property, if I is your identity matrix of order n, then its rank will be n only. What happened, Avinash? Okay. So if I is your n by n matrix, then its rank will be n. Second, rank of A, right? If A is your m by n matrix, yes, these operations are applied on matrix so that we can convert that matrix into its row echelon form. And after that row echelon form, we can find its rank. Okay. Now, we are going to see its example as well, but let us see first properties. So if I is your n by n matrix, so its rank will be n. You all know identity matrix, right? For 2 by 2, your identity matrix is 1, 0, 0, 1. For 3 by 3, your identity matrix is 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. So we'll get rank 2 over here and we'll get rank 3 over here. So if A is your m by n matrix, then its rank, its minimum rank will be 1 and its maximum rank will be minimum of m and n. Right. Its maximum rank will be minimum of m and n. Okay. So based on this property also, we are going to see this. And if O is your zero matrix, this is O, right? If O is your zero matrix, then its rank is zero, right? Zero matrix means your all the elements are zero in that. Okay. So one more property. Rank of a diagonal matrix, if I have to find, rank of diagonal matrix, that you can find directly by counting its number of elements in its principal diagonal or leading diagonal. Okay. So number of non-zero elements in its leading diagonal or principal diagonal. So now, so let us see now questions based on this. Okay, there is one more thing about elementary matrix. Right, but if I will show you that now, elementary matrix, then you will get confused. So that elementary matrix I will show you at the time of respective question only. Okay, so let us start questions. Now, so this is your 2 mark question. Wait, no, sorry. This is your 1 mark question of previous year. they are asking us to find rank of 1 4x4 matrix which is having elements 4 5 6 7 11 12 13 14 25 26 27 28 and 43 44 45 46. Okay. Now let us try to find this rank of matrix. Now how you can find its rank? So see over here. I have shown you that first to find rank, you have to convert any matrix into its row echelon form. Right. And if you observe its row echelon form, I have shown you one staircase. Isn't it? कि आपको ये staircase याद रखना है. अब वो staircase में इन सभी star के नीचे आपके elements क्या होंगे? Zero. यहाँ पे ये सारे elements क्या होंगे? Zero. Right. So below your star, your elements will be zero. So our target will be to apply this row operations or this elementary operations, right? So that we can get this form. चलो, यहाँ पे anyone हम क्या apply कर सकते हैं पहले कि हमें कुछ मिले? Can you observe one pattern over here? Row one, row two, row three, row four कोई pattern आपको दिख रही है? ठीक है. If you observe over here. ये सारे आपके कंसेक्यूटिव नंबर्स हैं कि नहीं हर एक रो में? आ बद्दी तुम्हारी क्रमिक संख्याओ छे, isn't it? Yes, this is your sequence or not? हाँ. So, चलो समझोइन. So if they are all consecutive numbers, if you are subtracting, sorry for that, give me just a minute, its size is got changed. Okay.